next girl, she's from, where's she from now? She's gonna have to tell me. It's very close to here, I believe. No, she's not from Australia, we're talking about it. That would be impressive. That's a powerful radio station transmitter right there. Right? I think she can tell you when she comes out. Her name is Carly Burress. Carly! Come on out, Carly! How are you, lady?
So good.
Are you good? Come on out. Come and say hi to your homies out here.
Brenda, she's a heathen, Jane told me so. And her hair's completely flat, she doesn't even own a comb. So I took her to the beauty shop and threw up a prayer. Lord, please save her from that dreadful head of hair. Cause the higher the hair, the closer to Jesus. Tease it on up, see where it leads ya. Maybe to the altar or up to heaven's door. Here comes a knocking, got an answer for sure.
Hey, I'm Carly Burress, and I'm a country singer-songwriter from Kennesaw, Georgia. I started my career about 4 years ago, traveling all around the Southeast to Georgia, Tennessee, and South Carolina, playing country shows in anywhere from small bars to venues at the end of a gas station to amphitheaters in Atlanta like Verizon, where I sang with Keith Urban, and it's been the wildest ride and so crazy. So I grew up in a small town called Cumming in Forsyth County up in North Georgia. And my musical abilities really first came to light when I would play and sing in the little Baptist church that I grew up in. And lots of my friends and family played piano as well. And they sang, and they taught us how to sing harmony. We had singing schools, we had singings all the time. And musical ability was a huge part of growing up there in that church. And that's where I first really gained the confidence to get on stage and sing, and to play, and to continue to hone my craft.
For a new artist like Carly to make an impact and be heard in the industry, there are various routes she could take. The old Nashville model would have her getting a record deal, putting together a strong team to work a debut single up the charts, and then release an album. For artists making music outside the box, the grassroots approach can be effective. This allows artists to maintain creative control while building a foundation for a long career, and kind of empowers them to do things a little bit more their own way.
I've been able to learn so much about performing and stage presence and projecting my voice from playing huge shows as compared to the smaller ones that I'm used to, in bars and restaurants and churches sometimes, wherever I may be. Thankfully, I had the opportunity to open for Dwight Yoakam just a few weeks ago. It was at Atlanta Symphony Hall, and it was a last minute show, but being able to open for a country music legend like Dwight at a beautiful venue like the Atlanta Symphony Hall was a dream come true. It was amazing. And I learned a lot of things from that show for sure. Definitely just to get up there and be confident. And it's easy to feel like I'm not prepared for that, or, you know, I want this opportunity to happen, but am I really there? Do I really have what it takes to engage a crowd that big? And thankfully, through the encouragement of my manager and my friends and the crowd itself and even Dwight, I was able to get up there and just have the time of my life, honestly, and be so confident in my songs, and my voice sounded great and strong, and it was just one of those instances that really reaffirmed what I'm doing, and that I really enjoy it and that it's what I'm meant to do.
I feel it's your way, fire, we're down.
my advice for Carly moving forward would be just keep networking with artists, writers, industry professionals. Learn from everyone that she meets. Help anyone she can whenever she can. Take the time developing her songs and career. Write for at least an hour a day, even when she doesn't feel inspired. When she does feel inspired, write for more than that until she can't anymore. And always make music and career decisions that are true to her heart and stay humble throughout the process.
Thank you so much.
At the end of the day, no matter what my music career or what the rest of my life looks like, my number one goal is just to glorify God in everything that I do. And everything that I have is from Him, and everything that I have is to bring Him glory. So in all the decisions I make, and all the paths that I go down, and the kind of music that I write, and the things that I say and do are all reflective of that, I hope. And that's what I strive for, and that's what I ask Him for, is just to be a light for Him in the country music world, in whatever world I step into, and wherever He has for me to go. And He has given me so much joy from being involved in music, and I'm so excited to see where the rest of my career goes and where He's going to use me and the people that He's going to bring into my life in the next few years as I keep playing music and keep hitting the road.